Hello everyone, welcome back to SK Shadow, welcome back to the Classic Games series, where today I'm going to get copyrighted because the music in this is by the legendary John Williams, of course. If I don't get copyrighted, then, well, I'll be shocked. We are here with the very original Star Wars Battlefront 2. This was my very, very, very first shooter I ever played. This is the first one I ever played. This was released back in 2002, I think. Second one was 2005, I think. Yeah, something like that. It was like 2002, 2003 sort of time. Sort of in the middle of when the actual prequel films came out. If that gives anyone any context. As I'm sure you all know and can tell by the background, I am a Star Wars nerd, so come at me all you want, say what you want, I don't care. This was, still probably is one of my favourite games of all time. It has single player, where you can do the Clone Wars campaign, and then the Galactic Civil War campaign, which is what we're going to do. We're going to do one from each. Let's do the Clone Wars campaign, and we will start. I want to be a clone. Aggressive negotiations on Kashyyyk. We'll do the Battle of Geonosis, that's iconic.
Prevent the Separatist from leaving the surface, we must. Concentrate all firepower on the remaining Techno-Union ships. The rest of your units to the Great Spire, send them.
Wonder if that's actually Yoda's, voice. Wonder if that's actually, his voice actor rather than just someone doing an impression.
Pilot! Land in that assembly area!
Yes, sir.
Well, either it's me just watching that. I might have to cut that. This is a classic. Oh my god, this is classic. Oh my days. I love the black bars on the side as well. I don't know if the gameplay's gonna have that. No. Okay. Oh, it doesn't look terrible for back in the day. I'll be a standard clone trooper. Obviously, so classic Call of Duty series. I should probably properly introduce it. We've done the classic Call of Duty series in the past. We've done some Battlefield. Why not just do any game? We're gonna go back across all the classic games I used to play as a child. Well, I say as a child, I'm still a child at heart, but as small me. I just have some fun. I mean, this was my first shooter.
Master Windu has entered the battlefield.
Oh.
Enjoy the Techno-Union ships.
Okay, this feels weird. There is no sprint. Can I do a barrel roll? You can crouch. You can actually prone. Which is more than what you can do now. Right, let's go shoot some fools. So yeah, this was the birth of Battlefront. Obviously, it's come a long way. EA have done a fair job on Battlefront 1 and 2, which in their own rights are good games. Obviously, this had no pay-to-win mechanics like, let's say, Battlefront 2. Oh, Jesus. EA Battlefront 2 was plumbed in with many pay-to-win aspects at the start. I died. But in the end, they did make it playable. They did make it so you didn't have to do that. But this was just the pinnacle of my childhood. It was just incredible, this. I had hours of fun on the original Xbox playing this. The original Xbox was something else. Hey, there's Mace Windu. Obviously, graphically, it's not brilliant. It's a very old game. But I don't think it looks terrible. Obviously, you can tell in the background that it's just an image. And this is quite difficult as well. I don't remember it being this difficult. But yeah, this is just one of many, many, many maps. Obviously, you can do custom games, you can play online. I believe people still mod it. They might mod the second one a bit more. We're definitely going to play that as well. The classic Battlefront 2. My second favourite game of all time. But yeah, this was basically the birth of any form of conquest, I believe. So this whole concept of conquest, going around capturing command post, and then you can spawn back there, and ticket system. There you go, the medic droid. Stand by that. Heals you up. But yeah, oh, this is just bringing back. This is just nostalgia all over. Got the spider droids. Oh, you can even got a pistol. This was just a very simple game. Just Star Wars. Obviously, George Lucas had his own development company for this as well, I believe. By George Lucas Games, and then obviously he sold that to EA, along when he sold everything off to Disney. And obviously the only other developer that is actually allowed to make Star Wars games is TT Games, and obviously we got the new Skywalker Saga Lego game coming out. Either, I think it's next year actually. They've delayed that many times. I've died. Right, we're going to quit to the main menu. We're going to travel over to the Galactic Empire because, yeah, there's not much. There's these massive ships in that, which you technically have to blow up, but it's whoever runs out of tickets basically wins, and I just like watching the cutscene at the start. So, Galactic Civil War. I want to play as a Stormtrooper. That is what I want to do. I'm going to keep this video quick and simple. I can't run. I've not done this before, apparently. Desert Extermination or Siege of Mos Eisley. Do we do Mos Eisley? Yeah, we'll do Mos Eisley. We might see the Cantina Band as well. I'll give anyone 10 points if they can name that character. I'll give you 10 points.
Cool. Local smugglers from Mos Eisley have escaped with the rebel droid.
Right, I can't listen to that voice. Jesus Christ, that was the worst impression of Emperor Palpatine I've ever had played in my ears. The time has come. Execute Order 66. Yeah, that was literally like Order 66 in my ears. Oh, that is a good looking Stormtrooper. Oh, you got more things here. Dark Trooper. Huh. See, it's quite interesting the way a lot of these early games have to stay away from spoilers. Because if you realistically think of it, take the original Lego Star Wars game. That came out, oh Jesus, that came out before all three prequels had come out. So technically you found out that Anakin had his legs chopped off before the film came out. Depending on who you played as, because that had like a sort of like an alternate ending. Because if you kill him as Obi-Wan, then the legs come off. But then if you do it the other way around, Anakin, he actually does kill off. What'd you call it? I don't know why I'm concentrating. If you kill him off as Obi-Wan as Anakin, then he burns, or Obi-Wan burns, and that's it. Cool, alternate ending. And there's a few games that have done that as well. So yeah, obviously no auto-healing in this either, so you either go up to the medical droids or you pick up those. They give you health. There's also like ammo packs and stuff as well. Because you actually have proper ammo in this rather than overheating your weapon like you do in the new ones. And this game is just way ahead of its time. Like, what other game A, looked like this, and B, played like this back then. I died. I went on a 17 kill streak. It's offline. Calm down. Let's try something else out. What are the snipers like? Oh, Christ. That was your scope. Interesting choice not to have an ADS feature. But probably game limitations, I assume. Rather than... Ooh. A choice, I guess. Because in the second one, or Battlefront 2, the original one, you could actually sprint, so. But you couldn't roam as far as another way. It's some interesting choices, gameplay wise. Yeah, this sniper's really good. Okay, right. I've tried out some gameplay. I'm not going to end the video there. That's just way too short. This would be like 10, 15 minutes otherwise. What I'm actually going to do is head over to Instant Action, and I actually want to see what maps they've got and then have a flick through some maps. See how much content there is. Yeah, there's two... I remember the... this was my favourite, actually. The best bin platforms. I want to try that. Oh, then you choose whether you want it in Clone Wars or Galactic Civil. We'll do that, because why not? And you could actually fly in this as well. You could fly ships and stuff, which is cool. Geonosis Spire, I don't know what that is. Hoth Echo Base, that was a fun map. I remember that. Kashyyyk Docks, I remember that one. Topoka City, of course. What was the islands for? Can't remember the difference. Oh, yeah, the one in the night. I know that. Yavin 4 Arena. Is that the one with the temple, or was the temple a different map entirely? I really don't remember. Renvar Harbor. Oh, yeah, Renvar. That was interesting. And he had the Citadel. Yeah, that was an interesting map to actually put in, because you've never had Renvar in any form off screen time. This is like the only place I can recall that this planet exists is in this game. Yeah, I know all these maps, but I want to specifically play my favourite one there. And that, does it scroll down? I'm pretty, because I'm aware you could play, yeah, Jabba's Palace. And there's Jabba there. Let's just launch it with that one for now. See, this loading screen is incredible. And there is a mod that actually brings that back into Battlefront 2. Oh, the newest one. I am a rebel. That's cool. That's fine. Oh, I can choose like that. That's cool. No, I want to be a rebel because I'm pretty sure they got... Oh, that's iconic as well. But let me try fly. Oh my god, the flying is better than bloody... Yeah, the flying's better than the latest game. Oh, yeah. Why didn't they keep this sort... I would have kept these sort of physics in for Squadrons. So I'm not going to lie, that game, that Squadrons blows. That along there, that used to be like the choke point where everyone would just face off. And I used to absolutely love it. Because I must have been playing this back when I was like seven or eight. Like, yeah. Never came back though, this map, for the second game. Just love that sound. Right, here we go. Yeah, everyone would just fight for this command post in the middle. I believe there is a first-person mode as well. don't know how you find it. Oh my days. And it is horrible. So we're not going to do that. Oh, difficulty's on easy. And I said it was difficult in the other one. Okay. I got blown up. I have been blown up and I've got to travel miles. I only remember the gonk droids and the medical. Someone just landed an X-Wing on me. There we go, we can spawn in the middle there. Yeah, that was my favourite map. There you go. I don't really necessarily know why, because it was basically a carbon copy of the Topoka City, just in Cloud City. So, you have that. Single, we'll go back to instant action. All I want to see is Jabba's palace. I want to see what Jabba looks like, and then we can move on. We'll play it in the Clone Wars. I can hear Jabba. Oh yeah, the Rancor was in this as well. Oh, where's Jabba? Where's his throne room? Ah, and fun fact, Temuera Morrison does actually voice the clones in this. Oh my god, there's Jabba. He doesn't actually... Oh my, I forgot that happens. He doesn't look terrible, I was about to say. That Rancor doesn't exactly... That's all I wanted from that. I wanted to see Jabba. Right, that should end off this very cool video. Still going to be copyrighted over this music, that's fine. So thanks for watching. If you want to see more classic games like this, or if you've got any suggestions for some classic games you want me to play that I may never have played, leave them in the comments. Anyways, like, subscribe, check all links in the description, and we're going to be back before the next video of the classic game series, where we're going to be playing the classic Star Wars Battlefront 2. See you soon. See you soon.